design of Beam. Hello everybody, welcome to my video. Today we're designing the beam. We already have design of slab as in this figure here. We designed a slab on a previous video, and this slab that we found to be this slab thickness is found to be 175 millimeter, and now we're going to design our beam. The load of the slab is transferred to the beam because obviously the beam is underneath the slab. So this is the load of the slab, and it's transferred to the beam. This is now the beam, and that's the total load of the slab with a uniformly distributed load of 75.737 kilonewton per meter. On the previous video we calculated this load. Every calculation is in there. The previous video is the design of slab. Every calculation of loads are in there, and if you want to know how it's calculated, you can go back there. Now let's go to the design of our beam. When you design a beam, consider a typical ground floor corridor. Reason for that is ground floor is always have the most traffic area, and that's where we get our tributary area. To locate the tributary area, you need a floor framing plan. Whichever is your framing plan, if it's typical, you just choose one floor framing plan and locate your tributary area. Make sure that the tributary area that you're choosing, you choose the tributary area that has a maximum area. Alright, and then here's the specification data. FC prime is the concrete, 21 MPa, and the FY is 400, that's for steel, 400 MPa. MPa is a megapascal. Mega means million, and pascal is newton per square meter. So therefore, 21 MPa is actually 21 million newton per square meter. And same true with the steel, which is 400 MPa. When you have that is the concrete, 21 MPa. When you have a beam section, at the centroid you draw a line, and that's the neutral axis of the beam. Above the neutral axis is a compression zone, and below the neutral axis is a tension zone of the beam. The compression zone is carried by the concrete. This is a compression specified strength of the concrete. Compression zone is concrete, and whereas below the neutral axis is a tension zone of your beam, and that is where we reinforce it with the steel, because concrete doesn't have a strength at all to carry a tension load. So that's why reinforcement primarily is at below the neutral axis, the tension zone of the beam. Now a design constant, N, there's K, there's J. We're going to be using the R, which is R is equal to 1.289 here in our formula here. And the beam has 1, 2, 3 sections. Number one is loadings. Little A is dead load. Dead load is the weight of the beam. And since this is a preliminary design, we have to assume the appropriate size of dimension of our beam. And here I assume that the width of the beam to be 250 millimeter and the depth of the beam is 450 millimeter. And letter B is a superimposed load, is IL. The superimposed load is installed after the construction of all structural members. There are three of them. Number one is ceiling, it's 0.5 kPa. And number two is the weight of floor finished. They allocated it to 0.75. And the movable partition is 0.981 kPa. These are the superimposed load. And these two here, the A and B, are considered dead load. They are dead loads, and therefore they are dead weights. So the total superimposed load is 2.231 kPa kilonewton per square meter, and the lab load is 4.8 kPa. We calculated that during the first video, during the slab design video. Number two now, design analysis. The ray moments. There are two moments. Moment due to wind load. The moment due to wind load here is 11.025. I cannot show you the actual calculation of the beam moment due to wind load because it's quite long. There are a lot of beams in this building. There are three stories of this building. We have to solve the moment of each beam due to wind load, and then tabulate them. And on the table, you choose the largest moment of the beam due to the wind load. And this is I have chosen two. The largest of all there is 11.025 kilonewton meter. Number two is the moment due to dead load and live load. Dead load and live load, these are the slab load alone. Okay, these are the moment due to the slab, and the slab is carried by the beam. Therefore, the moment due to the slab load is transferred to the beam. So we solve the moment using the formula M is equal to W L square over 12. It's a continuous beam, both ends fixed. Now moment due to dead load plus live load is 227.211 kilonewton meter. That's from the previous calculations during the slab design. If you want to go back there, you want to look at that, how we get this 227.211. The total moment of the beam is equal to the moment of the slab, which is 227.211 plus the moments. There are two moments here. See this S? The first moment is the beam moment due to wind load, and the second moment is the moment of beam due to its own weight. Alright, so if you add the slab moment and the wind load moment, you get 238.551 plus the moment of beam due to its own weight. Alright, we get this. So but before we get this, we have to calculate the moment of beam due to its own weight is by calculating the weight of the beam is calculated by calculating the volume, the total volume of the beam. The beam and slab, they have the same span, 6 meter span, and the beam is assumed to be 250 by 450 millimeter, and since they're all meter, we convert that, so it's 0.25 times 0.45 times 6, that's meter, That's the volume of the beam multiplied by the unit weight per volume. This is 24 kilonewton per cubic meter. We get the magnitude of 16. Total weight of the beam is 16.2 kilonewton. These three here are cubic meter when you multiply them, so therefore cubic meter is cancelled right here, so that's why we get the 16.2 kilonewton meter as the magnitude total weight of the beam. And since we strip the slab at 1 meter strip, we also have to strip the beam at 1 meter strip of beam. So the total weight of beam is 16.2 kilonewton. We strip that, we divide it by 6 at 1 meter each. We get the uniformly distributed load due to the beam weight of 2.7 kilonewton per meter. And since our load of the slab, the load of slab is also factored load. If you want to go back to the first video, you can see it's a factored load. Okay, since we factor the load, we also have to factor the load of our beam. Now let's factor that load. So 2.7 kilonewton per meter, 2.7 times 1.4 is equal to 3.78 kilonewton. The factored load recommended by ECI code is 1.4 dead load plus 1.7 live load. We don't have the live load here because it's just the beam weight. We're just calculating the weight of the beam. So now moment due to weight of beam is equal to 3.78 times if you're using the formula of MWL square over 12, so W is 3.78 and the L is the span of 6 meter, 6 times 6 times 3.78 divided by 12, we get the moment of the beam. Moment due to the weight of the beam is 11.34 kilonewton meter. Now we have to add that in here so we can get the total moment of beam. So these two added together, you get 238.551. Now plus the moment due to the moment of beam due to its own weight is 11.034. We get 249.576 kilonewton meter. That is now the design moment of the beam to be used in the design of the beam. Number three, now design of the beam. The effective depth of the beam is given as D. The effective depth is equal to the square root of the maximum moment, the design moment, divided by R, B. The R is 1.289 and the B is the width of the beam. It's 250 millimeter. This is the depth of the beam. We use the B. Okay. So D now is called the square root of 249.576 kilonewton meter times 10 to the 6 millimeter divided by 1.289 times 250 the B right here. And since we need a millimeter output for this formula here, and since we have the kilonewton meter, we have to convert that to newton millimeter. In 1 kilonewton there are 1,000 newtons, and in 1 meter there are 1,000 millimeters. So therefore this is multiplied by 10 to the 6. There are six zeros to be added here to the 249.576 kilonewton meter. Multiply that by 10 to the 6, you get 249 million 576,000 newton millimeter. We work this out, divided by 1.289 times 250, we get the depth of the beam now to be 880 millimeter, but B is equal to D over 2. As per ECI code recommendation, that ECI code recommended size for rectangular beam is at least B is equal to D over 2. B is 1/2 of the depth. So therefore, following the ECI code recommendation, we get the B is equal to 880 divided by 2, we get 440 millimeter. There we go. We design our beam. We have the width of the beam and the depth of the beam. This D here is the effective depth of the beam from the top of the beam to the centroid of the reinforcement, and below the centroid of the reinforcement there's 50 millimeter concrete covering. Also, the ECI code recommended the minimum concrete covering for steel is 50 millimeter. You can go bigger than that, larger than that, but this is the minimum given by the ECI code. And if you want the total depth of the beam, you have to add that 50 millimeter to 880 millimeter. You get the total depth of the beam. That's the design of our beam. We designed the slab and we designed the beam, and next will be the column. And that's the end of the video. I hope you like it, and thanks for watching.